police agencies for attempting to serve a felony arrest warrant in Northeast Baltimore. At the time, our worst fears became a reality. Shots were fired, two officers were hit. As a result, our officers, one from Baltimore City, one from Baltimore County, were shot and had sustained gunshot wounds and were transported here to shock trauma where they are receiving the best treatment anywhere in the country. This was a collaborative effort between federal, state, and local agencies to apprehend a violent offender. The task force was charged with identifying and apprehending violent offenders in our city and is supported by multiple agencies from local, state, and federal government. As we know, crime has no boundaries. Gun crimes affect us all. We ask that you keep our officers in your prayers as we go out each and every day to serve and protect. We ask that you keep their families in your prayers as they stand by their sides as they recover. This is a dangerous job that the men and women of Baltimore City, Baltimore County, and all of our state and federal agencies, we wake up every day and we go do it for the people of the city we live in. We do it every day to make this a better place to live, work, and visit. I want to thank all of the agencies who are involved. I'll list them: the Baltimore City, Baltimore County, the Maryland State Police, Maryland Transit Authority Police, the Drug Enforcement Agency, Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearm Agency, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, U.S. Marshal's Office, Homeland Security Investigations, School Police, Department of Public Safety and Corrections, and U.S. Secret Services. This time I'll turn it over to Chief Hyde.
Thank you.
Partners to fully investigate this matter.
this time, we'll take a few questions.
Commissioner, I know it's early, but can you at least walk us through what led up to the shooting?
Well, what we know right now is that we were serving a felony arrest warrant on an individual who was wanted for a felony in North Baltimore. This task force identified this individual and was at that residence. At some point, the suspect was outside. What we know now is that shots were fired. Our officers were hit. The suspect was hit and was fatally wounded from his gunshot wounds. And our officers were then transported in, but they are recovering from their representations.
So the suspect was outside armed?
Yes, sir.
Were there children involved in the incident?
At this time right now, we believe that this suspect was the only person involved in this warrant service. And it was the only person we were looking for.
Was this a former corrections officer?
That's part of our investigation. So we're working to identify everything about this person that we can identify. Right now, what we know is that he was wanted for a felony crime.
Can you identify the officers?
Sorry?
Could you please identify the officers?
It is not time for us to do that now. We have met with their families. We have met with the officers at the appropriate time.
How long has the officer, city officer, and county officer been on the force?
But you said they're both veteran police officers.
Thank you all.
Thank you.